H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
Now, what are the different locators that we have discussed? What are the different locators that we have discussed? ID, name, link text, and XPath, CSS. These are the main thing. Of course, we also discussed some tag name. I mean, I said there will be some kind of by tag name and all. Okay. So basically, these four properties are basically based on the identification properties, like some properties, some attributes of the objects. Okay, I can say these four are the based on the attributes of the objects, based on the properties or attributes of the object. Okay. And these two are the based on the location of the objects. Okay. Yes. So these four are based on the properties are attributes of the objects. Like basically ID might be a property, name is a property, link text, it's not a property, but basically it's name of the object. Okay. But tag name means, again, tag name is also based on the HTML properties. Okay. Now here XPath and CSS, basically it's based on the location of the objects. Location of the object means where our object has been placed in an application, where the object has been placed. I will show with an example here. Before we understand in depth of this locators, we will try to understand this one. Now we will try to understand, we'll go with an example here, a simple example. First of all, I am trying to understand the concept. Okay. First we will try to understand the example, then we will go with the actual XPath concept. Okay. Of course, we will derive the XPath concept from the example itself. Say for example, I am talking about the computers family. Okay. Here, say I am talking about computers. Okay. Here, say we have a desktop and say we have a laptop. Okay. And here in desktop, say we have HP models, and again HP, we have say M1 model, M2 model, model number 1, model number 2. Just assume this is a family of the computers, and these are the computers. Okay. Computer, again computers, desktop computers. Laptop. Okay. Again in the desktop, HP model, these are the model number 1, model number 2, say Dell, again model number 1, model number 2, you know, model number one, model number two. Okay, so it's, this is a laptop. Okay, just assume the same kind of things are also there in the laptops. Okay, yeah, you don't observe here. I'm talking about computers here, desktops, laptops, and say these are the brands and these are the models. Okay, now say, just for example, here say I'm talking about M1. Say I'm talking about M1. Now I'm just saying M1. Just I want to know about the information M1. Now here my questions are like, say, what is the brand? What is the brand? Okay, and whether it is a laptop or desktop. Say here, just for example, here I want to know about the information M1. Okay, what is the information? I want to know about these two. I would like to know the information about these two questions. Like, what is the brand of M1? What is the brand of M1? Whether it is a laptop or desktop. Can anyone answer? Can you answer this question, these two questions now? Can you answer these questions? Hartha, what is the M1 model? What is the model? What is the brand of M1? What is the, whether it is a desktop or laptop? Yeah, I'm saying M1 is there in, if you observe here, M1 is there in SP, M1 is there in Dell, okay? M1 is there in Sony, and it is there in desktop, it is there in laptop also. Then how can we say? I'm saying M1 is the brand, M1 is the model which is available in all the brands, and it is available in desktop and laptop. Okay, I'm not talking about the expert concept, I'm just talking about this concept. Okay, so can we answer these two questions now? I'm saying I would like to know what is this M1. Okay, what is the brand of M1, whether it is a laptop or desktop. Can we answer these two questions now? Yes or no? Yeah. How, Uma, you are saying, and Priya, you are saying, why you are saying HP laptop? How can you see that HP laptop?
By default, it takes the first one.
I'm saying I'm not talking about XPath.
It takes okay? The first one.
I'm saying I'm not talking about the XPath, okay? And even the first one is also a desktop HP here. It's not laptop, okay? Yep, that's correct. Here basically, you know, I'm trying to make you understand the concept, okay? If you already know XPath, you just ignore this, okay? Maybe probably don't get confused. Yep, see here, this is very good example for those people who don't have knowledge, idea on the XPath, okay? Now see here, when I say M1, here I cannot say what is the brand and what is the, whether it is a laptop or desktop. Simple, because here M1 is there here in HP, and it is there in Dell, and it is there in Sony, and it is available in desktop and laptop. Okay. Now if I want to uniquely mention this M1, okay, if I want to uniquely mention M1 here, see here, say the first question, this is the first question, say question number one, question number two, question one, question two. Say if I simply say M1, if I simply say M1, probably I cannot answer this question. No, I cannot answer this question also, right? Otherwise, instead of no, we can say cannot answer. Okay. we cannot, with this information, if I say, if you simply give M1 and if you are asking me these two questions, I cannot answer this question, I cannot answer this question. So probably if you give something like this, HP M1, so you gave information like this. In this case, I can answer first question, right? I can answer first question. I cannot answer the second question. Are you following me? Are you able to follow this? Now, so if you simply give information like M1, okay, probably I cannot say, I cannot answer both of the questions here. So if you give information like this, HP M1, I mean, say model number 1 in HP, what is the brand? If you ask me a question like, then I can say that, yes, I can answer the first question, but I cannot answer the second question even, because again, HP M1 is there in desktops and even laptops. We cannot determine it. Okay, we cannot answer this question. Now here, laptop HP M1. Okay, now here I can answer this question. I can answer this question. Till this point, any questions here? On this example, till this point, any questions here? See, yes or no are clear. Yeah, fine. Now, see here, I can call these are the XPods. Okay. So, if I want to uniquely mention, okay, if I want to uniquely refer a particular model here, I have to give some information like this. Okay. Now, in this case, if I want to represent this M1, okay, so this M1 only, I want to represent, say, for example, this M1 only, or say this M1. Okay. I want to identify this M1. In this case, I have to mention desktop/sony/M1. So, if you simply say M1, it cannot recognize. Okay. If I simply say Sony/M1, that it is going to recognize. Does it going to recognize? If I say simply Sony/M1, it's again an ambiguity, right? Here Sony M1 is there, here in desktops, here in laptops, right? I want to uniquely refer this. I want to refer this particular object here. Okay, I want to refer this. So here if I say simply Sony/M1, it is not going to recognize that. So I have to mention something like desktop/sony/m1. Okay, these is called as XPod. In terms of technically, we call it as XPod. Okay, I am mentioning the location of this object basically. Okay, desktop/sony/m1. I am mentioning like this to have a clear picture on this. Okay, now see here. Now there are two things again. In XPath, there are two things. One is absolute path, relative path. Okay, we can represent in two ways. One is by using absolute path. Okay, the second one is relative path. Okay, now here, say, I am talking about absolute path and relative path. Say I want to represent this. Absolute path for this one would be like this. Computers. Okay. Desktop. Sony. M1. And say the relative path for this one might be like this. Now, if you all observe here, in both the ways, in absolute, by using absolute path, by using relative path, we can able to recognize this M1 uniquely here, right? Now, see here, in absolute path, I have started from the main parent here, computer/desktop/sony/m1, or even in relative path, if I say simply desktop Sony M1, even this is also going to uniquely recognize this M1, right? There won't be any ambiguous. Of course, if I simply say Sony slash M1, probably this might be a problem. Okay, probably this may not recognize properly. I cannot uniquely refer this particular one, right? So here, this path is also going to recognize this M1. But here I'm not starting from the parent one. I mean the main parent. Okay. Now here in this case, for this object, I can say this is an absolute XPath and this is called a relative XPath. Okay. Now which is the preferable one? Any guesses here? Can you say yes, no? Which is the preferable path? Absolute or relative? Any guesses? I can see two answers. Okay. If you are able to recognize the object using relative path, prefer relative path only. Don't go for absolute path. Why? Because, just for example, say here, say earlier we have this kind of structure, okay, computers, desktop, laptops, simply, okay. Now see here, for example, okay, say on top of desktop, say we have one more thing like some heavy computers. I'm just trying to explain the concept as I said again. Okay, say earlier we had computers and directly desktop, laptop. Say before this desktop, say it has been introduced something like heavy computers, and say here some lightweight computers. Just an example. Okay, lightweight computers. Again, lightweight computers, laptops. Say just for tablets. Some iPad, like this. Okay. Again here, in heavy computers, say in desktop, and we have something else, XYZ. But however, now if you all observe here, now this hierarchy has been changed now, right? If you depend on absolute path, now this absolute path is not going to work. But still your relative path, there is a chance that your relative path is going to work, of course. You may ask, like, in between this desktop, Sony, if something has been introduced, of course, in that case, our relative path is not going to work. But however, the probability of failing of a relative path is very less in this case, right? It's like from the lower level, there may not be any major changes. However, even the changes, we can't do anything. We have to update our relative path. But if you depend on your absolute path, if a single thing has been changed in between that hierarchy, you have to change your absolute path. Okay, that is the reason I am saying, in either ways you are able to recognize your object. Okay, so in that case, if your object is recognizing using relative path, prefer relative path only, don't go for absolute path. Okay, now here, technically here in terms of XPath, just observe here, now say this I said in general, say in terms of XPath, this is going to be like this. If it is absolute path XPath, it is going to be represented with a single slash. Okay, that is going to be represented with a single slash. If it is a relative path, it is going to be mentioned in a double slash. Okay, are you following here? If it is absolute path, it is started with a single slash, and it will start from the main root hierarchy, computers, heavy computers, then desktop. Here you may ask, like, XYZ and desktop are like siblings. Okay, desktop parent is heavy computers here. XYZ is not the parent. Okay, XYZ is a sibling here. Okay, now see here. So if I want to represent, now in this case, computers, heavy computers, okay, and then desktop, and then Sony, and then Sony and M1. Okay, this is the absolute path. Now this absolute path is not going to work out. We have to change it again. But if you look at this, this absolute path is still going to work out. Okay, so prefer relative paths. Prefer the relative paths. Okay. Now, say for example, any questions till this point? If I add some more things to here, any questions till this point? Yeah, great. Just for example, say here I said HP model number 1, here also I said HP model number 1, or here Sony we have model number 1, here also Sony model number 1. Just assume in this model number 1, say for the desktop, say just the monitor size is say 21 inches. Just assume in the desktop model for the model number 1, say HP is providing 21 inches monitor. Okay. Now say here in Sony, again the same in the laptops, for Sony, say for the same model number 1, say it's been providing with 19 inches monitor. Just assume. Now in this case, now I can write my XPath in a different way. Okay, instead of the simple paths, now here I can write a XPath using these attributes. Now this is the attribute of this model number 1. In technical words, I can say this 21 inches is the attribute, right? Like the screen size. Screen size is the attribute of this model number 1. And 19 inches is the attribute of this model number 1. Now I can differentiate this model number 1 based on this attribute. How? Yep. See here, we have been using a one formula. If you remember, I gave you one formula as of now just to write some XPaths. Now see here, I can represent or I can differentiate this model and this model, this M1, okay, this M1 and this M1, I can differentiate. Now see here, you can see Sony, okay, and here Sony slash M1, here attribute, what is the attribute? Screen size. Okay, if I say 19 inches, okay, it is going to represent this M1. Under Sony, it is going to represent the M1. So even here, I don't need to mention laptop here. Okay, probably may ask why I have included Sony. Say for example, here for other models also, if you have anything like 19. If you don't have a 19, of course, you can directly use like this. What I'm saying here, then I have used Sony. I can remove Sony if you have a confidence that there is no model number 1 with 19. Say this in HP, say it is 18 inches. Say in Dell, say it is 17 inches. Okay. And here, say here 17 inches. Some 18 inches. Now if you closely observe here, among all these model number ones, there is only one 19 inches. In that case, I can use this XPath directly model number 1, and by using its attribute, I can represent this one. Okay. Now here, say if there is a model number 1, say here this model number 1 with the same 19 inches. Again, this is a problem, right? Again, here we have model number 1, 19 inches, model number 1, 19 inches. Again, to establish the uniqueness, we have to mention Sony slash M1 screen size 19 inches. Okay. So even here also, if you have 19, of course, again in that case, again we have to write a desktop slash Sony slash M1. Like that we have to write. Okay. I'm just saying an example here. Okay. So here in Sony, we have 21 inches. M1 with 19 inches. So probably you can write a logic like this. Okay. Sony slash model number 1. Screen size like this. Okay, yesterday we have discussed the same thing. Okay, now let me take one more example here. Say for example, say there are three friends. Okay. Say two are say two are Indians and one is from say Japanese. Okay. See here, again two Indians, say there is one male and one female. Okay, or say just two males. Again here two Indians are males and of course all of them are males. Just assume all of them are males. Here, who am I? Now here, I can represent say, okay, here. Let me consider like as of now. Let me say here, say three friends, and I'm seeing all of them are males, right? So there is no use of for me. So here, say I want to represent one Indian here. So I can say here like this, Indian, and probably like Indian of zero. Here we have two Indians. Okay. If you have Japanese, if you want to point out a Japanese, you can say simply Japanese. Simple. Because you have only one Japanese, you can simply say that Japanese. Okay. Say if you have Indian and there are two Indians. So if you want to represent one Indian, you can say Indian of zero. Okay. And say again the same example. Say one is male and one is female. And I mean our Indians I'm talking about, say the same example, two Indians. Okay. And again among these two Indians, one is male and one is female, and then one is Japanese. In that case, probably I can represent like this. See here. Now see here. Can anyone of you guess how can I represent? Say I want to represent female, an Indian female. Say here we have three friends. Okay. Say there are three friends and say two Indians, one Japanese, and among these two Indians, one is male and one is female. Okay. Now I want to represent male or female. Say I want to represent female. How can I represent? Any guesses here? Any guesses? Can you post in the chat box? Any guesses? Here, I know the better, of course, you can write in any way, but the best way is, okay, see here, Indian, okay, again in Indian, we want to represent a female, right, so here the property is gender, so at the rate, gender, female. Okay, so Indian and the gender female, like this. Okay, now let me go to the actual one. Till this point, any questions? I can see one question, and apart from that, any other questions here? Let me copy these questions. If you have any questions, please post over here. Okay, till this point, any questions? Please post here. Now I will go with the actual application. Now we can take any application. Yep, let me take eb.com here. Now observe here, if you remember here, if I want to know the properties of this text box, I said right click on this. Okay, I said inspect the element with firebug, right? Now basically it is highlighting this particular section and it is showing the relative properties here. But if you close the object here, this is the hierarchy of the objects. Now can you all observe here? Okay. I'm keeping my cursor on this. Now just observe the application. It's slowly increasing its... now can you all observe here? If I keep my cursor over here, it is just highlighting this text box only. If I keep my cursor over here, here, it is just highlighted that entire section. From this section to this advanced section, it is highlighted. Okay. Now let me go here. Now see here, I'm simply changing its focus. Now see here. Now previously it was just highlighting only this section. From this section, from this search to this advanced. Now if I keep my cursor over here, it is just highlighted, either highlighting from this AB to this section. So if you all observe here, I'm just keeping my cursor over here in the hierarchy here. Okay. So whatever the hierarchy that we have been talking about, now this is a hierarchy, right? The computers, this heavy computers, desktop, this is a hierarchy. Okay. Now basically our this HTML applications, our web applications will be represented in a hierarchy here. Now see here, if I keep my cursor over this, it is just highlighting the entire HTML page. Okay. Even if I keep my cursor over here, it is highlighting. Now see here. Can you all observe here? Just observe here. If I keep my cursor on this, if you read here, what is the class? Header. Now if I keep my cursor over here, it is highlighting the middle part. If I keep my cursor on this footer, it's going to highlight the this footer part. Now everyone over here, I kept my cursor over here on the footer, it is highlighting the footer section. Okay. And then if I save in this header section, see here. If I keep in this header section, if I keep my cursor on this, again it is reducing. See here. It's just that particular page has been divided into mainly three parts. One is header, middle, and then footer. Okay. So then this header also, if you observe here, there is a kind of divisions. This is one division, okay. There is another division. There are two divisions. Can you all observe here? Okay. So this is how your page will be divided into parts. Now, what is XPath? If you remember, I said XPath and CSS are based on the location of the objects. So now, in this basically, location means here where we have placed our object. Okay. Now, say if I want to represent this particular section. Now, if I want to represent this particular section, how can I represent? Probably I can start, if you ask me to explain about the absolute, I will say HTML, body, okay, and then this division of class header, and then again this division, this first table. Okay, now if you all observe here, when I keep my cursor over on this line, can you all observe here in the below there is a small pop-up is coming up. If I keep my cursor over there, it is showing a small pop-up. Can you all observe over there? Below to my cursor, there is a small pop-up is showing, which is showing HTML /HTML /body /div/table. Can you all observe that? Are you observing it? That is called as absolute path. By default, it is going to show if you keep your cursor, it is going to show the absolute path of this particular object. Okay. This is called as absolute path. Okay. However, now if you want to build this relative path, probably we can take this table. So that was the absolute part. Whatever we were able to see on the below to my cursor, that is called as absolute part. Say as I said, absolute part is not preferable one. So if I want to build a relative part, say I want to build a relative part for this particular section. Okay. Now here probably what I will do here, say tools. See here, first of all I will try to use the formula that we had. Okay. Now let me take a new test case. Okay, what is the formula that we had? Now I hope everyone understands these formulas. The best example again for this formula, if you want to remember this formula, here I said, here this model number 1 is 21 inches, this model number 1 is 19 inches. So I was uniquely recognizing using this model number 1 with screen size, I mean with some property, attribute. Okay. Again, don't stick exactly to that, just try to understand the concept. Okay. So here model number, okay. Now, here, what is the HTML type? Say if I want to represent this section, the center section, I want to find out the center section. What is the HTML type of this? What is the HTML type for that section? What is the HTML type? It is table. Can you all agree here? It is table. Okay. Now, see here I can mention table. Okay. And say here for this table there is a property class. So we'll try to recognize using this class. So at the rate, here we have, what we have to mention? Here we have to mention property. What is the, I mean attribute. Class is the attribute. What is its value? This one. Now let me say fine. If you all observe, this particular section was getting highlighted with a green color border. Can you all observe over there? It was highlighting green color with a green color border. Okay. So this is going to work out. So it is something like this. It is something like this in our Excel. So I have mentioned the model number 1 and I have here at the rate property and its value. Okay. Now here there might be some complex. Yep, this is all about XPath. Okay, in simple words, this is all about XPath. Any questions here? Now we'll now we'll get into the tables. Before we will get into the tables, any questions here? Any questions? I think there was a question from Anil. I think Anil. Sorry. I think Anil, you were talking about some section here, about right? I was talking about header, middle, footer, right? Again, you are talking about this. Basically, script means it is whenever you see here this script, the tag as script. Basically, here when you do some operations here, when you do some operations in the background, there will be some logic will happen here in this case. What is this just talking about? Can you all agree here? It is saying some jQuery. It means script means this. Whenever you see something called script, it is not related to your HTML page. Okay, it's simply some logic or some function that is going to be called in our script. Say probably when you click on search, say you enter some camera here and you click on search, it has to pull out the data from a database, right? So it has to query. In other words, it has to query the database. Okay, so that you can find here as part of script. As part of script, you can find this. Say it is doing some kind of a jQuery. Okay, it is going to the database and it is going to try to retrieve the values. Okay, so whenever you see something like script tag, basically it is related to JavaScript. Okay, where you are going to mention your logics. Okay, even if you can find there is a .js, .js, .js means it's a JavaScript file. Okay, it's not related to UI.
H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.